Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, ladies and gentlemen. A very warm welcome to a new edition of our TechXchange webinar. We are very pleased that you take your valuable time to join our 30-minute session today. My name is Daniela, and I'm happy to guide you through this presentation. Before we start, just a few information. This webinar is live and will be recorded, so all your microphones are muted, and if you have any questions, please use the Q&A section on the right side of your screen. We will answer them at the end of the session. If we don't have time to answer all of them, we will get back to you after the webinar. So if you add your name, we can directly approach you. In our TechXchange webinars, we give you technology insights into reciprocating compressors. Today, we will look into compressor assessment, and these are our three key takeaways of today. Reach your sustainability goals with an action-oriented assessment program. Enhance reliability with specifically designed analysis methods. Optimize compressor performance by eliminating bad actors and root causes. We are very happy to have two experienced colleagues as speakers today. Both have assisted many compressor users on site around the globe. On the left, you see Vitaly. He has more than 12 years of experience in the gas compression industry, being responsible for the design, calculation, and implementation of compressor upgrade and revamp solutions. And we have Alexandro here, compressor specialist, technical major, event management. He has more than 23 years of compressor experience in machinery diagnostics, troubleshooting, and technical support. And both played an active part in the compressor assessment of the LDPE compressor fleet that we will talk about today. And with this, I hand over now to Vitaly.
So, thank you very much, Daniela. Good day, ladies and gentlemen, from my side. It's an ethylene LDPE combined production plant with quite big capacity, and the compressor fleet, which we are going to discuss today, we actually look into LDPE part of the plant. Here, conversation goes about two production lines, which have 9 compressors in total, 3 different types, designated as a booster, primary, and hyper compressors. And actually, all compressors except one primary are running without any redundancy. So except primary block, which has 2 running compressors and 1 in a standby, all other compressors have no standby. And that practically means that in case of shutdown of these compressors, it directly impacts an output of the plant. These 9 compressors featured in 3 types are non-Burckhardt compressors, all compressed in ethylene, but design greatly varies, mainly by size and power. So if we speak about booster, it's 500 kilowatt prime drive power, up to hyper compressors, the biggest one with a 5 megawatt power. It also different size, 4 crank, horizontal opposite compressors with different amount of stages, 3 stages for boosters and 3 for primaries. For hyper, it's 2 stages. What is quite interesting for this plant is actually a wide range of operating pressures in which these compressors are operating. On the suction of a booster, we have nearly atmospheric pressure of 1 bar, while discharge of the hyper is about 2,000 atmospheres, from which gas is taken basically to the reactor. The plant is running from the 90s. It was commissioned in early 90s. And since that, it's in operation. And our client, he has conducted internal analysis, looking basically what are the issues and problems in operating of those plants. And the conclusion, first of all, was that it no longer meets the requirements and performance demands of the customer. Specifically, the unreliability of these 9 compressors greatly affected an output of a product of this plant. And one of the primary requests and targets was to debottleneck plant capacity, which was restricted because of unreliability of the compressors. Compressors were running approximately 30 years, but by the time of assessment, however, there was a plan to extend and continue with operation of these machines. Therefore, the question of insurance of long-term reliable operation was put in place. It's a short one, but very important factor was safety and environmental concerns because of the specifics, especially of the hyper design. There was a significant amount of oil spills and leakages, which represented an increased safety risks for personnel and maintenance specialists around these compressors. The requirement of client for analysis was that all findings must be arranged in a very systematic way with quantified justification of problems of bad actors which are there, and these recommendations are to be aligned in an improvement plan which will serve as a basis for improvement of the compressors over several upcoming general shutdowns of the plan. We came back with a suggestion to make a compressor assessment as a first step, named as Burckhardt Activate, and we believed at that moment, of course, that it actually responds to the demand of the client to have a structured, prioritized action plan for improvement of condition of these machines and addressing these three requests and points. But before we go to things which we actually implemented for improvement of reliability, let me please explain shortly a process of what has been done with Burckhardt Activate. In general, we offer quite an extensive portfolio of assessment and diagnostic solutions at Burckhardt. We have a digital solutions portfolio where we use our products for a remote analysis and diagnostic of the compressor condition with assignment of appropriate recommendations and suggestions. However, we also can go on site to make an on-site assessment, which we call a Burckhardt Activate. We have several or two basically main levels of Activate, a complete, which we do regularly and as a rule, and I will show you what specifically we have done for this customer, and more focused, where we use advanced methodology for diagnostics such as pressure volume analysis, time domain vibrations, with the help of prognostic technology. We also have a specific Activate scope for a specific marine and offshore applications, where we look not only on a compressor but rather on a complete cargo handling system. The process of Activate itself is rather straightforward and quite simple. I would use this simple flow chart to guide you through steps and actions which we have done in this specific assessment case. So planning basically is about definition of scope, which tools to bring with us on sales side for data collection and measurements. And this is quite important because typically we have quite limited time on site, limitation on availability of a customer personnel as well. So preparation is of course important, especially because the scope of collecting data is rather extensive. Here you see the things which we typically collect during a survey. Of course, we have the qualitative part, which has discussions with technical personnel, with operators in charge of the compressor, with process engineers to identify targets and the objectives of request for assessment. That's in a way of reliability and sustainability, efficiency and emissions reduction on the compressor. We of course looking at maintenance history is an important component for identification of bad actors. In particular, we are interested about failures, outages, and the scope of maintenance interventions which have been undertaken with those compressors. Operation and maintenance practices review is something what we do during the technical meetings. It's also very important to collect an experience of operators with this compressor so far. But we don't limit only to that. We go for visual inspections, walk around, checks on the running compressors, and of course measurements. So here we have roughly two types, which is a snapshot, which is taken over a quick, typically 1 to 2 days measurement. However, we also do a continuous monitoring or measurement data with a case where we leave data collecting equipment for several days or even weeks for specific failures and modes, to identify them and to collect information about them. And we, speaking about snapshot monitoring, it's typically a vibration measurement. It's a temperature detection on external surfaces. We speak here about valve covers, leak lines, inlets and outlets of heat exchangers, especially if instrumentation is not installed there, that provides quite valuable information. Gas leakage detection, if we have an access to compressor parts like piston rods, plungers or cylinder liners, we can measure roughness, we can estimate the wear or measure wear condition of the components. That's, of course, for an understanding of conditions of tribological operation of joints, which are very critical for reciprocating machines. This is not only things we do, we also look for parameters. Instant readings are available on the panels. We also look for trends of gas parameters like pressures, temperatures, flows, and gas composition eventually, electric motor current, bearing temperature, and so on. So quite extensive analysis on operating parameters. And why we do that? That's basically a basis for an analysis which we conduct in-house. Here we involve typically subject matter experts, component design specialists, sizing experts or repair experts in case of need for corrective actions. In this specific case, bad actor identification because of the size of the fleet played a very important role. And here we used a statistical reliability analysis. It's a good method if you have sufficient data. You take information about maintenance interventions, failures over a certain period of time, typically 1 to 3 years. And then you calculate the first step in which state compressor have been spent which time. So how long it was in operation, what was the percentage of scheduled maintenances, unscheduled maintenances because of outages, how much or how long this compressor was actually required to be in production. And you can do it for, like in this case, for all 9 compressors, which serves for a further analysis and identification of different reliability related indicators. Here we speak about mean time between failures. Of course, with this information, you're able to calculate it, like shown here, and look for bad actors on a compressor fleet level. So for individual compressors, for example, here you see that 2 hypers and 1 primary showed the lowest, the shortest mean time between failure. But it's not only that. You look for maintenance intensity ratio, how much hours of maintenance was compressor per hour in operation, what was the use factor of compressor, availability, and so on. You can, or you should not only focus on the compressor fleet level itself, you go one level further, you go for a component or assembly analysis where you attribute failures which this compressor had experienced for a particular systems or particular components or assembly groups, like here, to identify what is a bad actor actually on a practical level of handling it from different compressor improvements. In this case, red mark is a crank gear related failures, which were present practically for each compressor, not only because of the frequency of them, but also because of the consequences. They represented a target for a reliability improvement, and basically improvement plan was largely focused on them. Once we do such analysis, we came up with report. This report, in this case, as in others, we do case-specific with implementation recommendations specifically for a plan. However, these recommendations, they need to be, of course, discussed with a compressor operator. It's not always possible to implement everything at once. There should be some timeline, and this timeline is based on criticality, of course, but it's also based on availability of compressors for modifications. It must be synchronized with turnarounds or general shutdowns, which are planned for a given production. So this kind of discussion is mandatory, and that has been done. In this case, why is that? Because this actually serves us a basis to prepare a concrete engineering proposal for implementation of these modifications. And In this case, we have considered several aspects. One is an upgrade of component design itself on a running gear. So we came up with proposal for every critical part of running gear based on a failure history, what can be improved. On engineering perspective, for new parts, let's say, like purely engineering and designing of increasing radii of stress concentration areas because of the fatigue cracks experienced earlier. On manufacturing side, improving roughness or quality of the surfaces by polishing in these critical areas, up to really design considerations like we did for bearings on the connecting rod and on the main bearings, with updating its design from a bimetallic to three metal bearing of special design, which on one side allows to have a higher specific load. On the other side, because it's a kind of special three metal bearing with a somehow thicker white metal layer, it also more stable and less susceptible for misalignment or impurities in oil. Tightening of a critical threads is also, or joints is also very important topic. Specifically for connecting rod bolts. Here we have replaced the actual mechanical hexagonal nut tightening with a hydraulic nut tightening for a better precision, for a better repeatability of applied preload on a bolt. And of course, when modifying the design of component, we also look for possibility of material upgrade for higher strength class, if it's applicable, but also on a coating side, because this is exactly where we can do something about prevention and elimination of wear-related failure modes. That was done for a crosscut shoes of this compressor with application of spray coating according to Burckhardt technologies and standard. That has been done for a crosscut pin with application of nitrated hardened surface, again as per our standard, which later on it will be shown in the result, proved also as a good and useful implementation for elimination of wear related failures. Specific things on the design improvement, like sealing and upgrading a layout of an oil distribution channel to make sure that oil is delivered to the running surfaces from a supply point up to, let's say, crosscut shoes or small end bearings, has also been implemented. But speaking about design of components, it's not only thing which has to be considered for a reliability improvement. And with this, I give a word to a colleague of mine, to Alex, who will bring it to a broader picture and other aspects which must be considered for improvement. Alex, please.
Thank you, Vitaly. Good day also from my side, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for your participation. So we'll go to the second step of improvement plan, and we speak here about the corrective actions. As part of the improvement plan, and this was clearly specified in the report recommendation, modification of the compressor component design only, as we was described before and explained, will not dramatically change the situation on site for the operation of the machine and reliability of the machine. Actually, the environment in which components are placed will play an important role in the reliability and operation of the machine. In this way, foundation overall, as part of restoration of compressor to foundation integrity, together with remachining of the running surfaces, as an example, the crosshead slides remachining of contact surfaces or the sealing surfaces required for elimination of the oil leakages, restoration of the component alignment together with modification on crank gear lubrication system were part of the correction actions. Next slide. We go to the last module from Burckhardt Activate process, which is a follow-up after implementation of countermeasures and improvements, which is important step. Actually, implementation of complex improvements usually require time and resources. In the same time, in some cases, fine-tuning and careful analysis of results after implementations are necessary. Therefore, evaluation of results is not only requested by the customer, it is also strongly recommended by Burckhardt. And we'll see how we'll do this in more details. Follow-up implementation of countermeasures and improvements. In this case, such evaluation started during commissioning phase of the equipment after modification, and this action usually include vibration measurements, extensive vibration measurement campaign using handheld devices and prognosed Swift, we'll see later. Temperature measurements on external surfaces and close observation of operating parameters and careful visual observation on the absence of the oil leakages. All these are part of follow-up action starting with commissioning phase. On a long-term perspective, tracking of the component's lifetime, periodic inspection to identify failures, if any, and failure modes are being performed by customer, of course, with support of Burckhardt compression. In more detail, in this case, such evaluation started during commissioning phase of the equipment. As a specific example of how detailed such evaluation can be, it's an application of advanced diagnosis system, as was explained, prognosis-based after implementation. In this given case, it was related to time domain vibration measurements to ensure correctness of actions and proper operation of the compressor after startup. We have an example here on this slide, how this look. PV diagram of a specific cylinder also has been measured for diagnostic purposes. Those system capabilities, we must know, are not limited only to vibration monitoring. It is also extensive applied for evaluation of energy efficiency of a compressor process with PV analysis before and after modification. So all these data are collected and analyzed in the commissioning phase and after startup. Results, where everybody wants to reach the results. Coming to the results of improvements implemented based on a true compressor fleet assessment, main following points can be stated. Improvements of long-term reliability and longevity, thanks to restoration of compressor to foundation integrity, vibration level on the crankcase has been reduced to by a factor of 2 to 3. This was proven during the vibration measurement campaign. In addition, by applying epoxy grouting on the during restoration on the foundation, the foundation is protected from degradation in case of sporadic oil leakages due to the specific design of this compressor. Oil leakages have been eliminated, which was one of the primary concern of the customer, and this was not due to aesthetic point of view, but primarily for the safety and environmental reasons. Last but not least, reliability increase of compressor together with reducing downtime of the machine and maintenance costs is the key deliverable of in this given case, with elimination of targeted failures mode. In particular, for this compressor, it was shown on failures related with crank gear components. These were only few results, good results, which were achieved after implementation of this program. With this, our presentation is finished, and we are glad to answer to any questions or comments which may arise.
Thank you, Vitaly and Alex, for sharing your experience. In order to continuously improve our webinars, we kindly ask you to provide us your feedback. We just shared a link now in the Q&A section to a very short survey. If you have a few minutes, we would very much appreciate it to know your opinion, and we're looking forward to hearing and learning from you. More information about the assessment, Burckhardt Activate, you can find also on our website. And if you are interested to stay informed about future webinars, you can always register here on our website so you stay connected. We are at the end of the presentation. Many thanks to our audience for joining us today. We very much appreciate your participation, and we hope that it was of value to you. Thanks again to Vitaly and Alex for the knowledge sharing. This recording will be provided on the Burckhardt Compression TechXchange website and will be also published on social media. Feel free to share with colleagues who may not have had the chance to join the live session. Wishing you a great day ahead, and until next time, goodbye.